If you are a portfolio manager, Projectum xPM offers great capabilities for you to manage all types of work that you want to connect to your portfolio. That be projects, epics, ideas, programs, or even strategy. So I'm going to show now how we can work with portfolios as a portfolio manager and how quickly we can establish that container for all the work we want to manage. So first of all, we are logged into Projectum xPM, and on the left side, I can go down to my portfolio section. As portfolio manager, I can see all my portfolios and also other people's portfolios. If I take the tech portfolio 2025, essentially we're opening up the entire portfolio where we can see that Christian is the owner of it. There's a description of the portfolio. It has an issue status, so that right now there are no issues, but it could be at risk or in need of help. We have a CapEx budget, which is important, that sometimes the management of the portfolio is the management of money and effort, so people's hours invested into different initiatives. In this case, CapEx is probably the key driver for most of these portfolios that we are seeing. So for 2025, the CapEx budget for my portfolio could be 3.5 million euros, or that's at least the example in this case. Out of these 3.5 million, we maybe want to distribute that money against certain drivers or strategic elements. In this case, we have distributed the money up against the complete set of business drivers that the company has, so that we have mandatory work, transformation work, differentiation, and so forth. So these are the percentages. And that means that there's right now 875,000 euros set aside for improvement type work inside the portfolio. So to begin the journey of balancing a portfolio, first and foremost, we have to go in and connect work items to the portfolio. So if we look at the initiatives tab right here, these would be all the initiatives of the project type. Some are large, some are small, but all of them connected to the portfolio that I manage. I also have all the related epics. So those could be the product epics or portfolio epics. So essentially also business cases on their own, initiatives on their own. And that's one of the things we offer in Projectum xPM is the ability to design the portfolio management experience the way you want it. And for many, it's not just traditional work anymore. It's also not just agile work. It's the combination of both, which is what we refer to as hybrid portfolio management. So here we have a variety of agile epics and traditional projects. We could still also have the programs as the container between projects and the portfolio, so the middle layer. So the portfolio or the program one right here will then have these projects below it. So all of this is essentially a matter of connecting the dots as a portfolio owner. The trick is then, of course, how do we visualize that whole dynamic way of managing a portfolio? Which brings us to the roadmap part. So if I click on a roadmap, then we have a predefined and pre-drawn roadmap or timeline for the entire portfolio. Let me just quickly expand it right this, right here. So here we see from the tech portfolio, which is the highest level, I have then my projects, then programs, other programs, and even ideas. I could also here have epics or any other type of work items. That's why we call it XPM, which stands for anything portfolio management. We also see the symbol here, this one, that actually shows that there's a connection between the biomatrix project and the program called program X1. If I click on the symbol, I can quickly see a dependency map, the from and to dependencies, which could be that biomatrix is delivering something that I need in the AI Sentinel project. And maybe if I zoom out, the AI Sentinel project will then deliver something to someone else. So the from and to and from and to dependencies. So that we have as a standard. And beyond this, if I do mouse over on each of these bars, I can then see more information. For instance, here, the start date, the end date, also description and KPIs. So this mouse over effect is especially valuable if you're going to, as a portfolio owner, share this roadmap visualization to your peers or your stakeholders, as we have a share button up here that allows you to simply send a link or a hyperlink that people will then receive. Once they click on it, they will then see this entire view, but in read-only format, where they can then do mouse over and see only the information that you would like them to see. Another important aspect about managing the portfolio is to balance it or prioritize it or even rank it. So the case of ranking, for instance, right now shows that out of the 3.5 million euros we've set aside for the portfolio, we are right now working with 3.536 that has been spent. So we have exceeded the budget with 56 something thousand euros. We can also see that we have still 2 million euros of work that has not been picked up. So how do we then manage this when we want to rank or prioritize? So if we look at the bar in the middle here, this represents the budget line. So accumulated, the running totals from the first selected projects here only allows us with the current budget to pick up project 1, 2, 3, and 4. We have also picked up this program, which is why we are exceeding the budget limit. So let's imagine that we didn't do any selections here at all. And instead we wanted to get some assistance from this solution in terms of what should we then prioritize. So we could optimize the whole thing based on benefits. And then it shows us that you should then start with this program, then this project, that project, and so forth. You could also optimize it by budget, by ROI, or by AI, which is something we cover in another session. So in this case, it shows us that we can select all these projects, but not the two programs, and then still be within our budget constraint. So alternatively, we can also manually move them up and down like this and say, no, this should go here and this should go there. So deciding on the ranking on our own. And finally, and maybe even for some most importantly, if we look at these two ones up here at the top, these are locked. And the symbol locked essentially means that these are mandatory to execute. So if we just quickly go here, there is this thing called must run. So we can't prioritize these. They have to be done. That's why they are at the very top of the ranking. So going back to the roadmap here again. So one thing was establishing which initiatives we should do, what we can afford. But then there's also the resource capacity constraint that we have to look into. So for each of these work items, there is typically also associated people that have been allocated to the work, also with hours and time-phased to some extent. So when I click on this symbol, I then see a heat map for the entire portfolio showing the consumption of all resources by name, or in this case also by role, so that I can see that Carsten in this case has issues in Q1, Q2, Q3, and I can then expand and then see which in the details of what he's working on. And sometimes this means when you are read that there is an overallocation, but it could also mean that people are on vacation or that they have less availability to do project work. There could be many explanations to this, which is probably what you would find out in a report and not right here. But here we have the ranking mechanism, we have dependencies, we have budget control, and we have resource capacity control as well. Let's go back from this one, like this. And just quickly touch that we also have, in this case, the initiatives again, here as one view. We have the epics, we have the programs, and we also have the risk matrix. This will show all the risks below the portfolio. So programs, epics, projects, wherever we want to create and capture risks, they will be rolled up and surfaced in one central view so that the portfolio manager can do summary reporting and send it to whoever needs to see your portfolio status report. And finally, on the categorization of work, here we often offer a, let me just go large screen like this, but we offer a Kanban experience so that the portfolio has a Kanban board. Right now we can see how we have categorized all the work. And if I move AI Sentinel to differentiation like this, you'll see that again, we can enforce rankings so that this is now number one in this row called differentiation. Demo 500 is number two, and this is number three. If I push it into this one, and then this is now number one in the mandatory work, but then Apollo Forge will be number two. And also notice that we have at the top the summaries in real time. So the current cost of all mandatory work is 2 million roughly euros and benefits 5.1. If I move this one to the transformation bucket, then transformation goes up and mandatory goes down. And the small parenthesis in the middle here or at the end of the name represents the work in progress right now. So the WIP. And some companies work with WIP limits. How much work can we actually have going on at the same time within a portfolio or within a business department or similar? So work in progress we have here, cost and benefit perspective and all in real time. So going back again from the Kanban board here, as a final thing worth mentioning is of course the dashboard. This is more a real-time chart showcasing everything that goes on inside the portfolio. And beyond that, if we go to the very top up here, we then have an AI-generated portfolio status report where there's a complete summary, including details for each project that we can then copy and share to our stakeholders. This again is the out-of-the-box experience of portfolio management. We can do a whole lot more, and especially when it comes to tailoring how you want to work with your portfolios in your specific organization.